In a previous video, we saw that each point in time domain represents a complex exponential in a frequency domain, whose magnitude is equal to the value of the function at that point, and the rotational speed depends on that instant of time. The reverse is also true, and each point in the frequency domain represents a complex exponential in time domain. Now, what happens if the signal is discretized? If we have a discrete time signal, then the signal in time domain has values for only discrete points in time. The points at which the signal is defined are called the signal sample times, and the associated signal values are called the signal samples. Each sample in time domain represents a complex exponential in the frequency domain with magnitude equal to the sample value, and having a rotational speed that depends on the sample time. The signal in time domain is the summation of all the samples, so its corresponding frequency domain is the summation of all the complex exponentials associated with each sample. This is called discrete time Fourier transform. The signal is discrete only in time domain. Frequency domain is continuous. Each sample corresponds to a complex exponential in the frequency domain, and hence the frequency domain representation, which is the sum of all of them, is continuous. So time domain is discrete, and the frequency domain is continuous. That's why we call it discrete time Fourier transform. Unlike the discrete Fourier transform, in which the signal is discrete in time and frequency. We'll discuss discrete Fourier transform in the next video. Unlike continuous time, the discrete time Fourier transform is finite summation of finite number of complex exponentials. That's because the time domain signal is defined only on certain points of time. Since n is integer, the frequency domain of discrete signal is the summation of harmonically related complex exponentials whose exponents are integer multiple of each other. Each complex exponential is periodic. The largest period is the one associated with the fundamental, or the complex exponential associated with the first sample, n equals 1. The fundamental period is 2 pi. The second component period is pi, half of the fundamental. The period of the third component is 2 pi over 3, and so on. From the graph, you can see that within each fundamental period, which is 2 pi, all the components repeat themselves, and hence the summation of all of them repeat itself each 2 pi interval. So the frequency domain representation is a periodic signal that repeats itself each 2 pi interval. The Fourier transform of discrete time signal is a linear combination of harmonically related complex exponentials, which is periodic over the fundamental period 2 pi. If the sample time becomes less than 1, then the fundamental period, and hence the frequency domain period, becomes larger than 2 pi. As the sample time gets smaller and smaller, and the samples get closer to each other, the frequency domain period becomes bigger and bigger. When the sample time approaches 0, meaning the time domain signal is continuous, then the frequency domain period approaches infinity. The frequency domain of continuous time signal is aperiodic. So discrete time domain signal corresponds to a periodic frequency domain, with period depends on the sample time. The larger the sample time, the smaller the period. Continuous time domain signal has aperiodic frequency domain. The reverse is also true, as we will see in a second. Just from analogy, if we have a discretized frequency domain signal, then each sample represents a complex exponential in time domain with magnitude equal to the sample value, and the speed of rotation depends on the frequency of the sample. since the frequency domain signal is the summation of all the samples. The associated time domain is the summation of all the time domain complex exponentials associated with each frequency domain sample. This is not the inverse discrete time Fourier transform. Recall that in discrete time Fourier transform, the time domain is discrete and the frequency domain is continuous and periodic. So the inverse discrete time Fourier transform gives us discrete time domain signal from periodic continuous frequency domain. I will discuss the inverse discrete time Fourier transform in the next video. But here from analogy, the frequency domain is discrete and the time domain is continuous and periodic. It feels like this is the inverse of the Fourier series. Recall that Fourier series gives us discrete frequency domain from periodic continuous time domain. At the end of this series of videos, I will discuss the relationship between all of these formulas. Discrete frequency domain signal is periodic in time domain, with period depends on the sample frequency. The larger the sample frequency, the smaller the time domain period. Notice that the smaller the sample step size, the more will be the components or the complex exponentials to be added up, and hence the larger will be the summation. The resultant becomes bigger and bigger as the number of samples increases. Continuous frequency domain signal is aperiodic in time domain. Throughout this video, you might wonder why the resultant of the summation of the complex exponentials has only real part. The imaginary part vanishes completely. That's because each left-hand sample that corresponds to a complex exponential rotating in a negative direction is accompanied by a right-hand sample that corresponds to a complex exponential rotating in the positive direction. When added up together, the real parts add, while the imaginary parts cancel each other. That can also be verified mathematically from Euler's formula. The summation of two complex exponentials with opposite frequencies is 2 times cosine, which is the real part. So the imaginary part vanishes since each complex exponential is added to another complex exponential rotating in the negative direction. So discrete time domain signal is periodic in the frequency domain, and discrete frequency domain signal is periodic in time domain. In the next video, we will discuss the inverse discrete time Fourier transform.